Mohamed Abshir Waldo is a consultant and analyst in Kenya. He joins us on the phone right now from Mombasa. Can you talk about what you think the two piracies are?
Well, the two piracies are the original one, which was fishing piracy by foreign trawlers and vessels who at the same time were dumping industrial waste, toxic waste, and it also has been reported nuclear waste.
Before, there were some people who were fishers and lobstering. But after that, there had come many big ships. Because there is no government, no seashore guard. So these ships came close to the shore. Sometimes, you know, there are fish, there are lobsters.
The problem was compounded by the foreign dumping of toxic waste. The tsunami of 2004 brought much of the evidence onto the shores. The elders told Sam they watched in anger as their waters were exploited and then poisoned.
I had to send a kid away.
Abdulwali is one of Sam's cousins who turned to piracy.
Markii aan arkay in macnaha maraakiibtii ku xamulka waan aragnay aan daraj aan u aragnay indhahay way qabteen. Iyagoo badda ku shubaya sun oo soo celiyay wixii badda noole ku jiray oo dhan sidaasaa macnaha aniga igu kaliftay inaan macnaha ama jiriif ahaado ama kaalgu ahaado isugu mid aanu ka dhigannaa.
The pirates looked at the horizon and saw the wealth of the world sailing past the Somali coast.
you can understand what they're doing. I don't think I'm not in favor of piracy or any other act of violence, but the source of the piracy is in the West, actually in Europe more than the United States. First of all, the waters near Somalia were used for fishing. Well, they've been heavily polluted by mostly Europe, Saudi Arabia, the United States marginally, even the toxic wastes. They've just destroyed the waters there. They can't fish.
In 1994, Italian journalist Ilaria Alpi and her cameraman Miran Ravatin were in Somalia investigating the use of Italian aid projects as fronts for arms smuggling and the dumping of toxic waste. But this was a story that someone didn't want told. They were both murdered. However, the story didn't end there. And 10 years later, evidence of toxic waste dumped along the coast of Somalia was uncovered by the 2004 tsunami.
We made two trips to Somalia. During the first one, we were trying to locate the sites identified by the UN where the drums were washed ashore by the tsunami. The witness accounts were significant. Fishermen and local people spoke of malformations, hemorrhagic disorders and previously unknown diseases.
Luciano Scalettani is a journalist for the Catholic magazine Famiglia Cristiana. As well as examining the illegally dumped toxic waste brought ashore by the 2004 tsunami, he also picked up Ilaria Alpi's leads, suggesting that toxic waste had been buried along the Garoe-Bosasso road. The road had been visited and filmed by the two journalists just days before their assassination.
We applied the following method. We used a GPS to identify the sites and a magnetometer to immediately verify whether traces of metal were present beneath the soil. We also looked for witnesses who worked on the construction of the road, to whom we asked what they had seen and that they accompany us to the sites where the dumping of waste allegedly took place. This is probably the most interesting site due to the extensive presence of metals underground. It's in a deserted place off the road, in a location where, technically speaking, there's no sign of human activity.
Famiglia Cristiana's reports shed light on an international scheme to bring waste from industrialized countries to developing ones. So profitable was the business that extremely creative methods for the disposal of toxic waste were devised. We went to the house of John Giacometti on the outskirts of Milan. He planned to drop free-fall penetrators filled with radioactive waste onto the seabed of African countries, including Somalia. Others, such as Giampiero Seppi, use more conventional dumping methods.
It might sound cynical, but I wasn't there to give away cookies or candy for children. I was there to import hazardous, toxic, or radioactive waste.
Giampiero Sebri acted as a local agent for an organization that arranged the dumping of waste in developing countries on behalf of Western firms.
If an industrial group or company, even a government company, has thousands of tons of waste to dispose of, I would set up a local company in a developing country. I would solve all logistical aspects, such as the ship and the containers. After that, I would load, unload, and that's it.
Sebri was also part of the so-called Project Urano, a plan to dump radioactive waste in Western Sahara, conceived by the same organization of international waste dumpers.
Something really strange happened while we were unloading our cargo. We were told that we could not dump the waste there anymore. This meant part of the load was still in the ship, while the other vessel that was arriving had also been traveling with its load of waste for 3 or 4 days. This boat was deliberately made to sink. The other was a ship that ended up in Somalia.
According to documents found by Italian police, following the failure of Project Urano 1 in Western Sahara, Project Urano 2 was devised. Somalia was picked as the new target for the dumping of waste in 1992.
The value of human life is equal to zero. The only thing that they value is money and more money. They just don't care.
Can you explain what IUUs are? In your article, you say it stands for illegal, unreported, and unregulated. fishing fleets from Europe and Arabia and the Far East.
Correct. And this has been known to the, both the countries in the West that had these fishing fleets, which included Spain, Italy, Greece, and eventually UK, and others who joined later, as well as Russian. And of course, there were many more from the East. And this problem has been going on since 1991, and the fishing communities and fishermen reported and complained and appealed to the international community through the United Nations, through the European Union, with no response in any form at all. They were totally ignored.
You've got the nuclear age now, right? And so with nuclear power, and I'm talking about positive nuclear power, like using it for things like electricity and whatever, you have a lot of remainder, which is now called nuclear toxic waste. They don't really know what to do with that stuff yet. So they put them in containers, and they got companies, private companies, which are hired by governments to get rid of and dispose of these nuclear toxic waste. Now, since the early 90s, when the government in my country collapsed, these private companies have illegally been dumping nuclear toxic waste containers on the shores of Somalia. Nobody was there to protect them, and the fishermen who was there in the coastal lines would complain time and again. It got to the United Nations Security Council and was ignored and thrown out. It was months after that that who we are now calling pirates, these men mobilized themselves, these fishermen, and got street militias from the streets and brought them on board into the ocean to protect the Somali waters. The truth is that all of that started because of these Western companies dumping nuclear toxic waste on our shores. And so that's the complicated scenario of my country. I would say that if you want the piracy to stop, stop dumping nuclear toxic waste in our country. It is much worse, much more heinous and sinister crime than piracy could ever be. What you're doing is you're trying to destroy a generation.